running out of time. I want it all, and I'm wishing they stop trying to turn me off. I want it all, and I'm walking on a wire, trying to go higher. Feels like I'm surrounded by clowns and liars. Even when I give it all away, I want it all. Just like fire, burning up the way. If I can light the world up for just one day, watch this madness turn to boucherie. No one can be just like me anyway. Just like magic, I'll be flying free. I'ma disappear when they come for.
The woods are awesome, right? Like, anything can happen in the woods. That's why they're awesome, not because of like the actual trees or whatever. So I guess it's like the idea of the woods that I really like, not so much the real wooded part. It's just, you know, I like adventures.
Dude, there's nowhere I'd rather be than in the woods right now. Well, except for maybe on the football field. Or with a chick. Or on the football field with a chick, right guys? All right, good talk.
Shall we? Shall we what?
Go back. I have math league. It's long division night.
Yeah, I have stuff too.
Okay, so here's the thing. We're not going back.
It's time for adventure, bros. It's time for escape from the daily whatever you do and take a hike through the wooded, through the woods. What do you say? Are you with me or are you with me?
Is there a third option?
The third option is also being with me.
What are we supposed to do in the woods? Start a fire?
It's gonna be so great, you guys. We're gonna meet up with a couple of friends of mine, canoe across this totally picturesque river, and pitch a couple of tents. And then we'll come in touch with Mother Nature or whatever, and maybe even like have a really good time.
But Mr. Sievergaard will come looking for us if we don't rejoin the class.
Yeah.
Well, I guess it's a good thing that I told Tony Fibonacci to tell him that I had really bad cramps and you two were nice enough to escort me home. Isn't it?
I love lying. I'm in.
And there's gonna be chicks there.
I'm in.
Come on, Pube, what is it? You afraid of chicks?
It's pubert, not pube. And I am not, in fact, afraid of women folk. My mother is a most fantastic woman, and she makes a mean grilled cheese.
All right, you're not afraid of chicks then. Then you're in.
How do you know I don't have a previous engagement? Fair enough.
I don't know about this, Valerie. My mom is gonna be pretty worried about me.
Don't worry about it. It's totally taken care of. I already called her and said you're staying at my place.
But what about Poe's mom?
I usually go to the cemetery on Friday nights, so she'll just think I'm with the dead. Mm-hmm. She's probably at her boyfriend's house anyway. He lives above a bar. He has a foot fungus.
You guys are not gonna regret this, all right? High five. All right. Pack up all your stuff, guys, okay? We're headed deep into the woods, bros.
You're gonna talk about this trip forever, you guys. Like, seriously, for eternity. When you're like 30 and have a boring husband and sticky kids, you're gonna be like, thank God I went with Val on that transformative camping trip my senior year of high school. I would totally regret not having done that, and it has added spice to my miserable existence. You know what I mean? Okay, let's go, ladies. It's time to start the rest of your lives.
How much further, Valerie?
Not much.
How do you know that?
I'm not head cheerleader for nothing.
That doesn't seem right.
Dude, bros, we're extra close.
To what? Achoo! There must be strange plant life in the vicinity.
Don't sneeze on my jacket, man.
Thank goodness for my ointment.
I miss you too, Valerie.
Hey, Brad, aren't you gonna introduce us to the birds?
Birds? What year do you think it is?
We got a live one over here.
My name is Brunhilde.
I'm Jake.
This is Poe.
A pleasure.
Hey.
Poe's the weird, silent type. Don't worry, she's not dangerous.
That is inaccurate.
What's your malfunction, Brittany?
You did not say that this was a co-ed camping trip.
Didn't I? Must have slipped my mind.
I'm not allowed overnights with boys, Valerie.
What's wrong? Don't trust yourself.
I'm just not allowed.
How about this? I hereby allow you to have this one co-ed overnight camping trip, okay?
It doesn't count if you say it. You're not my mom.
You're completely safe, I promise. Look, do it for yourself, okay? Maybe it's just what you need.
Hello, three women. I am Pubert.
Pubert? Wow.
It's a family name.
It would have to be.
And what might you be called?
Poe. It's a name of my own choosing.
So what's your real name?
It has been erased from the sands of time.
Okay, let's set up camp. We have a long day of canoeing ahead of us tomorrow, and we'd love to get some beauty sleep, right, girls?
I sleep with my eyes open.
Oh, I'm sure you do! Brad, did you bring the tents?
Oh, totally.
How many tents are there?
Three.
And who is sharing with whom?
I sleep in the nude.
I sleep with extra clothes on.
Oh, what do you sleep in?
A tent with another girl who understands the value of boundaries!
Oh, well, I guess I'll share a tent with you then, Brad.
I'll take leather jacket, guys.
It's Jake.
Sure.
I guess that just leaves us.
Don't worry about Pubert. He's not gonna bite you. I don't even think he would if he could.
I'll have you know I have a very strong jaw. But no, I don't bite. But I do snore, and I talk in my sleep. Mostly in riddles. Don't concern yourself about it.
I should be at Math League right now.
It's one night, Bruni. It'll be an adventure. I've always wanted to do this. Didn't we always used to talk about going on a camping trip? I mean, look at him. It's not like he's going to bother you or anything.
Whoa! Man!
Oh, okay. So he's probably going to bother you, but not like in a threatening way. You're going to have the time of your life, I promise. It'll be just like when we were kids. I've seriously missed you.
Fine.
I promise you won't regret anything. I mean, seriously, what's the worst that could happen, right?
Right.
What was that for?
I'm so sorry. I didn't realize it was you. Sometimes my training in various forms of martial art is both a blessing and a curse. Are you okay?
It takes more than that to hurt old Jakey.
Well, sorry anyway. What are you doing out here?
Having a smoke. You?
I'm just getting away from Pubert for a minute. He talks in his sleep.
At least he's dreaming.
I can't figure out why Valerie brought me out here. I'm not exactly a woodsman, and we aren't exactly friends anymore. We're not enemies either, we're just not anything. We used to have so much fun together when we were kids, going to math camp and playing math games and making replicas of ancient ruins out of graham crackers, but we're just different people now. I still like those things, and she likes cheerleading and boys! Sorry, I didn't mean to... I don't know.
You don't like boys?
I do in theory, but not exactly in practice.
Does that mean you've never kissed a guy before?
At math camp, Trevor Shebolt tripped and fell and I tried to catch him and his tooth cut my cheek. So no, I haven't.
Does this forest seem weird to you?
Huh? Oh, I don't know.
It seems kind of weird to me. Sort of, what's the word?
Ominous.
All right, well, I better head back to my tent before Poe starts performing satanic rituals on my stuff.
Sure.
Good luck with Pubert.
Thanks.
Probably would have been better if we had a tent together, huh?
How tall are you again?
6'3", babe.
Wow.
If your arm crosses the line, it comes back to you, a zombie arm.
Don't worry about it.
The river. The river. No, stay away from the water. Keep on the... Come back. You can't come back. The river. The blood. What is hiding beneath the river? You will pay for what you have done and what you have not done. Hades will know your name. Hades will know your name. The river. The river. Graham crackers. Star Wars.
And that's how I got my first touchdown.
Oh, you're so good, Brad.
Yeah, I know.
What's your right, Hildy? You don't mind if I call you Hildy, do you?
I don't know. Nobody's ever called me that before.
Then I'm keeping it. It's original. You're Hildy now.
All right.
So, what's your right? I think I should get to know as long as I have to paddle this thing across a damned river.
Oh, it's just a short story. Not a big deal.
Oh, yeah? I like short stories. Why don't you read it to me?
I don't think so.
Don't be shy because of me. I like stories and stuff.
Yeah, come on, Bruni. I need something to distract me from the smell of this, whatever it is.
It's medical ointment.
It smells like death. I like it.
Just a little bit, Hildy, for me.
Oh, all right. Just a little excerpt here. They floated, they glided on the water, making soft ripples as they went along. The sun shone down on them. They could see their way so clearly. The girl kept herself from making eye contact with the boy, though he was in such close proximity that she couldn't help but look at his features, which were both rough and smooth. His hair a tousled pile of perfection. His eyes like a cup of coke.
Forget her. Keep going.
Oh, he's right, Bruni. Keep going.
They laughed and chatted, and some of them paddled the canoes. The water was calm, though throughout it and around it is a fate they cannot know. A fate scrawled in blood.
Yes!
Blood pulses, for it wants more blood to join it. And blood it shall have. It's nearly feeding time.
Yes, yes, yes!
Ew! Bruni, what are you even talking about? That was gross.
Dude, that was dark. You sure that's not from Poe's diary?
Yeah, are you?
Well, I liked it.
It was sort of based on some stuff Hubert was saying in his sleep last night.
Me? That doesn't sound like me. I wouldn't say that.
You were yelling it, actually.
I didn't hear anything.
We were kind of busy, babe.
Oh my god, shut up!
This is much more disturbing than your story.
So, did Hubert also say those things about having eyes like Coco?
Oh, no. That was just, fiction, was it?
Blood. Someone does actually know the coordinates which we're navigating, right?
Yeah, bro. I GPSed it on my phone.
We're going to a beach!
A beach out here in the woods?
Yeah, and it's super deserted, so we can all be alone.
Alone together.
Exactly!
I didn't bring any beach attire.
Oh, just go in whatever you have. No one's gonna see us anyways.
Blood. The blood waits. It waits for us all.
Pube, you all right there, buddy?
So red it's almost black. Point of no return. Caverns of torn flesh.
Stop being a weirdo!
What? What did I do?
That was awesome.
You were talking about blood again, pal.
Are you feeling okay?
I can perform an exorcism.
Yeah, no, I'm fine, I think. Yeah, no, I'm fine.
How much longer, Brad? I don't want to get caught up in whatever this is.
We're almost there, babe.
I see, sure.
Oh, thank God. Don't speak too soon. I'm so ready for some super great beach ball party time action!
This doesn't look like a beach. I've seen beaches on TV.
Pube, you've been inflating that thing for like forever.
I have very small lungs.
Bruni, are you ready for some beach volleyball?
Sure, Valerie, whatever you say.
Heads up, babe! Whoa, you, calm down, buddy, calm down.
They're totally fine, Hubert. They just fell in the water. I know for a fact
Bruni
can't swim.
Go toward the
door. Shut up, Poe. You're making it worse. Watch where you're going. Now I'm all wet.
I'm sorry. It was an accident, I swear.
Hubert, what's wrong? What happened?
I don't know. He won't stop. He's hysterical.
Get it together, Poe. Hey. Come on, snap out of it.
Namaste.
What's wrong with her?
I'm exercising the demons, I think.
I have an idea.
Dude.
Well, nobody else was doing anything.
Well, he seems all right now. Let's give him some space and, you know, explore the beach.
Well, that's one way to do it. Hey, Hubert, how are you feeling?
Huh? What? Oh, no, I'm fine, I think. Yeah, no, I'm fine. I'm just going to get my ointment. Yeah, my ointment.
I exercised his demons. I'm gonna see if they come back.
You're all wet and sitting in the dirt. You're gonna get all muddy.
Seems appropriate.
Are you determined to have a bad time?
No, I'm just having one. I was coerced into going on this camping trip with people who are not my friends. No offense. I didn't get any sleep last night because Hubert talks through Stephen King stories in his sleep. And now I'm all wet because I got thrown into a dirty river, a river which one of our cohorts insists is some kind of death stream. My childhood friend is off fornicating with her dumb jock boyfriend while I sit in the dirt next to God's gift to women, Jake Ronson.
You know my last name.
Whatever. Everybody knows your name. You're that guy.
Am I?
Are we making this about you now? I thought I was complaining over here.
Sorry. What else do you hate?
Well, you did knock me in the river.
You don't hate me, though.
No comment.
And besides, it's not like I did it on purpose, and I think you should admit it was kind of fun.
I don't remember.
The water was pretty warm.
True.
And you look cute with your hair wet.
Shut up.
You don't take compliments very well.
I know. Sorry, I guess. I'm just better at math problems than people problems. Why are you nice to me?
Maybe. I'm a nice guy, and maybe I think you're okay. Maybe even better than okay.
I hope you know that those are pretty bad for you.
Oh, yeah? Huh. How about that?
But thank you for at least walking away from my face with all of those carcinogens.
You're welcome. What's this? Weird name for a river.
You're like the hottest cheerleader at Taft High.
Oh, wait. I'm more than just a hot cheerleader though, right?
Yeah, you're the hottest cheerleader.
Yeah, I know, but I'm other stuff too. Like, there's other stuff that's good about me.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Okay, so like what?
You're pretty.
That's the same thing.
Geez, Val, I don't know. You're fun?
You don't know? You must know what you like about me, Brad!
Come on, Valerie. You know I like you. It's just, I'm not good with words and stuff. You're athletic, you're funny, and you're not super dumb.
Uh-huh.
And you are a good kisser. And, your trail mix was pretty delicious. Can we kiss now?
Oh, okay. La 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 la. Is it like really foggy here to you?
Just adds to the romance, babe.
La 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 la. Are you stuffy? You're breathing really loud, like when you broke your nose playing against Van Buren, huh?
No, I'm not. And the only reason I broke my nose against them was because I let them break my nose. Yeah, I could football those Van Buren kids on the table any day.
Oh, I love it when you get all defensive about your masculinity. La 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 la. Hold your breath for a sec. Someone's watching. Pubert, are you being a perv again?
Pube, not cool dude.
Hello?
We should go. Let's head back to the campsite with the others.
Whoa. Going somewhere.
Hey.
Where? Oh, yes, hello.
What are you doing?
Just applying ointment to the affected areas as directed on the tube.
How are you feeling?
Fine.
What are you allergic to anyway?
All kinds of things.
Like what?
Corn, peanuts, spinach, pepper, mayonnaise, marshmallows, apricots, artichokes, walnuts, hazelnuts, basil nuts, pine nuts, pineapples, pizza, and the juice of three lemons.
Those are all foods.
Yes.
You don't put food on your arm, so why are they itchy?
I'm not sure.
How are things going over here? Pubert, how are you feeling?
Stop asking me how I'm feeling. I'm feeling fine, okay?
We were just checking in on you, buddy. No need to get upset.
Sorry.
Anybody hungry? I think I have an extra granola bar. I always have brain food for long division night.
You really don't mess around when it comes to math.
Hit me.
Hubert, you should probably eat something.
Hit me too. Pretty strange spot we got around here. Haven't seen anybody else on the old River Styx.
What did you say?
Oh, just, I haven't seen anybody else out here. Any boats or anything.
No, what did you call the river?
The River Styx. I saw a sign back where we were playing beach volleyball with Hildy's head.
A sign?
Yeah, you know, a sign that said River Styx. A big old wooden thing. Weird name for a river.
Wait a minute.
You know what that means.
Well, yeah, but I mean, it's not real.
How can you be sure?
The same way that I'm pretty sure a unicorn is gonna come galloping through the backyard with a leprechaun on its back.
Anyone care to enlighten me?
The River Styx exists as a boundary between Earth and the underworld, between the land of the living and the land of the dead, between us and Hades. The river is a pathway to death, and once it has been crossed, it cannot be uncrossed.
She's lost it.
If you try to venture back across the river, Cerberus will descend upon you, tearing with his claws and teeth until shreds of flesh hang from your body, like carne asada.
Nasty. But, what's a Cerberus?
Cerberus is the hellhound. He alone is tasked with keeping the dead from escaping the underworld to the land of the living. A three-headed dog, sometimes said to have the claws of a lion and a mane of writhing snakes. Cerberus is not to be trifled with, for he does the bidding of his lord and master, Hades.
That was amazing!
Right, it's Greek mythology. Mythology meaning it's not real.
Then what's going on with Pubert?
I have no idea, but it seems several things are happening there, both genetic and societal. Maybe he has psoriasis.
Let me ask you this. Pubert?
Hmm?
Are you allergic to dogs?
Oh, come on. Pubert has a Triscuit allergy. He has every allergy.
Yes.
Dun dun dun!
But what does that prove?
Cerberus is near.
Oh, come on! There could be a stray dog somewhere with just one head and no connection to Hades. A normal dog.
This is no normal dog. This is the hellhound.
Pube, buddy, why are you doing that?
I don't know.
Well, knock it off. You're freaking the ladies out.
I can't.
Stop it. You're bleeding. Ow!
Hey!
I'm sorry. I can't control.
Anybody got a spare granola bar? Thanks.
Someone has to say something.
Go ahead.
She's more your friend than she is mine.
I can hear you, you know.
Where's Brad?
I don't know.
You've got an awful lot of blood on you.
Yeah, a lot.
This rope is really chafing.
It's for your own safety, man.
Valerie, can you tell me what happened?
I still think we should get out of here.
Not until we know what's going on.
But Brad said I was hot and then we made out.
Brad must be a biter.
And then it got like really foggy and like kind of dark. And then I heard this really heavy breathing. I thought it was just Pubert being a perv.
Hey.
And then I called out to see who was there, but nobody answered. And then I had this really awful feeling like we were being watched. And then Brad said that we should go. And then this dog.
Uh-huh.
Well, it was like a dog, but it had three heads. Anyways, it said...
It spake to
it
you?
It said, going somewhere. And then the fog got thicker and thicker. And then I heard sounds and yelling. And I just ran. I left him there. Oh my God, I left him there with that thing!
Valerie, is this your blood?
I don't know. I don't think so. Nothing hurts. Is it worse if it's my blood or his?
There. We all have to die sometime. It might as well be now.
Okay, I don't know what's going on, but we gotta go.
Not until we know what happened to Brad.
Hildy, look at her. If that's Brad's blood, and I'm assuming it is, he ain't coming back.
Oh, God, what are we gonna tell Mr. Severgard?
Okay, everybody grab all your stuff. Does anyone remember where we left the canoes? Poe?
This is all my fault.
The Dark Arts don't concentrate much on directional skills. We probably should. Easier to find the ceremonial mummified cat.
I'm such an idiot! Look at what I've done!
Easy.
No! I brought us all here so that I could just get to be with Brad, and now...
You brought us out here just to make out with your boyfriend?
Yeah. I mean,
you
I just...
You needed to say that you were with someone who nobody could think would get in trouble.
My parents are just really strict.
So I'm here, wherever this is, in mortal danger because I am so incapable of doing anything considered dangerous or interesting that I am your lame-ass excuse to your parents? Is that what you're saying?
I'm sorry, okay?
And
I'm stupid.
Hubert and Poe and Jake, they're all here just to cover your bases. Is that right?
Well, if Brad's dad got suspicious and called Jake's dad, then, he would say that they were with, with Pubert.
And nobody could ever think that Pubert could get in trouble because he's such a dork, right? And Poe and I are your excuses. Tell me, who's lower on the cool scale, me or Poe? Or are we all just such losers that you can't even tell us apart?
Hey!
I said I was sorry! I didn't think!
No! You really didn't.
Hildy, take it easy. She's been through something.
Let's go.
We can't go. He won't let us.
Yes, he will. Grab your stuff and let's get out of here.
You
remember where the canoes are.
You know I'm right. You come for us. You come for us all.
Oh, is that true? Are we gonna die?
No! We just need to stick together. Come on. We have a canoe to catch.
Hello?
Yes! Run! Run!
Bruni, I thought you said you knew where we were going.
So did I. I was sure it was... I don't know. It's so confusing out here, and it gets more confusing the darker it gets.
Oh, can we rest for a sec? I need to sit down.
The one person who knows we're going to the woods wears wedged heels? Fine, let's take a break.
Poe, you've been awfully quiet.
Just thinking about what I want my last words to be before I die. I was thinking, quoth the raven, nevermore, but it feels a little predictable.
Don't joke. This is serious. Someone is dead.
No, someone is missing. He might be fine, just maybe he doesn't have all of his blood.
I heard it, you know. The dog. I heard it laughing.
It laughs? I think you're just hearing things.
It laughed at me.
I wanna go home. We gotta get out of here. Get me out of here. I've worked so hard on my body, I can't just die. Do you know how many sit-ups I've done? How many pizzas I didn't eat? Sure, it sounds like incredibly superficial to you, but it matters to me. And I wanna get married, I think. Or have kids, probably. Or at least like a dog, like a teacup poodle or something. I can't just die.
Calm down. The last thing we need, the last thing any of us needs is to get hysterical. We can't be far from the canoes.
You're pretty cool under pressure.
Well, it takes a lot of patience to assemble your own at-home Tyrannosaurus Rex in a bottle.
He's here.
What?
The fog.
Yes, you're probably right.
This is crazy! This doesn't sound like me!
Pubert! We gotta go! We gotta get out of here! Pubert, stand up! Use your legs! Come on, snap out of it!
Hildy...
Oh, it's like taking a dolphin for a walk! Use your legs! You're a traveling nightmare!
Hildy, turn around!
Oh dear!
Run!
Okay, Brunhilde and I will get in one canoe. Valerie and Poe get in the other.
How is Poe going to paddle fast enough?
There's another paddle, idiot.
Use it.
But I have weak arms. I'm always at the top of the pyramid. Can we all just take one canoe together?
Five people is too many for one of these canoes. We'll tip over.
There's only four now.
Where's Pubert?
Being digested, I imagine.
Oh my god!
Okay, great. Let's all get in one canoe, said if it tips over, we're all dead. Okay, I love it. Who cares?
Everybody hop on and I'll push us off and hop in.
Not that I care, but where's Valerie?
Oh, come on!
Valerie! Valerie!
Valerie is a little busy at the moment.
Oh boy!
Finally!
What am I looking at?
I am Cerberus.
Hey!
Salutations.
Brad, bro, is that you?
Totally. Kind of. Not completely, but yeah.
We are the shadows of our former selves.
Okay.
And we, like, totally serve Hades now.
Forever and ever and stuff.
And you will join us.
There is nowhere to run. There is nothing. There is only death for you now. Hades awaits. You have crossed the river, and now you must remain in the land of the dead. Your only companion, eternal darkness. Your only comfort, the permanence of your surroundings.
Awesome!
And what if we're, not wanting to do that?
What you want is of no concern. I did not bring you here. You came of your own volition. You have sacrificed yourself to Hades.
We have what? Brad, you stupid jerk! You brought us to the underworld for a vacation?
Sorry, lady bro.
We did not choose this, oh Cerberus. We did not choose to fall down at your almighty paws. We were tricked by our idiot friend, and we'd like to leave now, your eminence.
It's a dog, not a sultan.
I go freely.
What?
I want to. I'll fit in better in the underworld than I ever did in high school. I mean, what kind of job was I going to get after graduation? How many noses can one person pierce before they fall into a permanent depression? It's for the best. And even if I didn't want to, he'd just drag me out with his multiple sets of teeth anyway, right?
Which is what's gonna happen to us!
No, it isn't.
Well, if you think we're gonna just volunteer, you're crazy.
Trust me. I'm ready.
Pow!
Oh, wow. Wow.
You serve Hades now.
I serve Hades now. Bad.
Do you give yourselves up freely?
Oh, screw that! Get in the boat, Hildy! Get in the fucking boat!
Just move!
Oh, go! Just get out of here!
When Achilles was dipped into the river Styx, his body was made impenetrable, but for the ankle his mother had held him by. You swam in the waters eternal, and now your body is as strong as the roaring river. Go, for you do not belong here, and you must not return.
Still mad I pushed you into the river?
I thought you were...
Well, I'm not. Is that all it takes to get you to kiss me?
Yes, just almost being trapped in Hades with Brad for all eternity.
Hey, I heard that.
Now let's get the hell out of here.
Pickles, leave a message.